As you pass by, I wonder if you found out if you had 24 hours to live, would that be the first thing you would do? Would you, like my little friend, start to panic? 24 hours, is that it? Is that all I've got? Oh, time is so short. How could I be taken so young? People often say. Oh. I heard it said of a 70-year-old man. He died too young. How can you die too young? You die when you die. There is a day set. Are you ready for that day? Would you go into abject panic and say, I haven't done everything on my bucket list? My bucket list still has 57 items on it. What am I going to do in my despair? Is that what you would do? Would you panic? Or would you be a bit more pragmatic? Would you say, actually, if I found out I had 24 hours to live, seeing as it's Christmas, what could be better than making memories with loved ones? What could be better than spending my time with the people I love, friends, family, people who fit into other categories, whatever those categories are? Is that what you would do? Well, I've got 24 hours. I want to make memories that'll last a lifetime for those I leave behind. Now, you might not have family and friends that you can go to. You might say, well, actually, I'm at odds with my family this Christmas time. I fell out with a son, a daughter, a mother, a father, a brother, a sister years ago. I had a woman tell me she'd not spoken to her daughter for 19 years. Her daughter wouldn't have anything to do with her because of a disagreement 19 years ago. If you found out you had 24 hours to live, there's no time like the present, is there? You might want to make things right here and now today while there is yet time. Because if you've only 24 hours to live, then there's no point saying I'll leave it till next week, because that's not going to work. And so, isn't that right, my friend? You do it every day, exactly. You've got to make things happen every single day, because there's no guarantee of tomorrow for anybody.
No one's perfect.
No one's perfect, my friend.
Perfect.
Exactly, not of ourselves. And so, that's the big problem we have. We don't know when our day's going to come. We don't know when the hour's going to come, do we? And so we've got to work on, what are we going to do? What does our bucket list have on it? What are the things that are important to us? Well, at Leicester Square in London, where they do all the premieres for the films, I asked this question. A guy went, I would do heroin. That's what he said. He said, I would do heroin because if I had 24 hours to live, I'd live like there's no tomorrow. Because literally, there's no... Exactly, it's a sin, isn't it? He was only joking. He said to me afterwards, I'm only joking. This lady said to him, you can't do that. You would kill yourself. It would ruin your life. He said, well, I've got 24 hours to live. But that's the thing. What is our priority when we find out that day has come? Now, some people might say, do you know what? I think it's a bit cold now. So if I found out I had 24 hours to live, I'd jump on the first plane to a hot place and I'd spend my last 24 hours sat on a beach drinking a sangria. As the sun sets on my life, I would watch the sunset in a hot location, in a holiday paradise. Or you might have a special purchase in mind. Is that you? If you found out you had 24 hours to live, you say, well, it's just burning a hole in my pocket. I might as well spend it now. Now, here's one. I wonder if you've ever thought about it. I wonder if you have a bucket list that you're working through. Is this one on your bucket list? What about getting right with God?
That's the one.
Is that on your bucket list, friends?
That's got to be the one.
That's got to be the one. So people think about all these things that really, in the passing, they're done. That's it. Once done, always gone. But if you get right with God, that doesn't just last for the here and now. That lasts for eternity. What was that first in your mind? Were you thinking, do you know what? If I found out I had 24 hours to live, I'd want to get right with God. Because a lot of people say, do you know what? I'll get right with God on my deathbed. I'll do it there and then. I want to enjoy my life for now. Why would I bother with a question like that when I just want to enjoy my life? So here's the problem. What if you don't get the time, yeah? All of a sudden you get hit by a car, you have a brain aneurysm, whatever it is. I had an 11-year-old friend at school, did my last sports day with him. He went out in the summer in Bolton, got hit by a car, dead, 11 years of age. You have no guarantee of tomorrow. So here's this question. If you had 24 hours to live, and friends, the clock is ticking, just because you don't want to deal with the question, that clock is ticking regardless. Do you know, time is the one commodity that all people have that once spent can never be reclaimed. Once you have spent your time, what you have done with it is for time and for eternity. If you don't spend it wisely, it could have implications beyond the waiting room of this life. This might be 70, 80, 90 years. Beyond death is an eternity that lasts forever without end. And so here's what the Bible says. We've got a problem, okay? So we've got a problem. The Bible gives us a clear warning. And then just because we like a happy ending, everybody likes a happy ending, we've got a solution to the problem. So every person within the sound of my voice passing by has a problem, as do I. This problem is this. Look at what the Bible says. It's appointed for men. It does say men, but it includes women. It's appointed for men and women to die once, but after this, the judgment. So what happens when you stand before a judge? Does anybody know? When you stand before a judge, you are being declared either innocent or guilty. The judge is weighing up whether you are innocent and free to go or guilty, and you have to be punished. On the day of judgment, God is going to judge every single human being. And you know the problem with God as judge compared to an earthly judge? An earthly judge gets given a set of evidence that might be right or wrong. An earthly judge can be given false evidence. The God of the Bible as judge sees everything that you do in the private of your bedroom at night on your computer screen. What do you watch? God knows exactly what you watch. God sees everything that happens. God even knows what you're thinking when you watch on your computer screen in the privacy of your bedroom at night. God, who is a judge, judges justly. Did you say get a job, sir? Did you say get a job? I have a job, it's this. Thank you very much, sir, for your comment. I appreciate that, not a problem whatsoever.
Have a nice day.
And so here's the thing, that God as judge can judge perfectly and justly. He never makes a mistake. Thank you, sir. God as judge never makes a mistake. He can lay your life before you and all of it will be true. The good things and the bad things.
Well, is it right that when we get, before we get to Jesus?
You have a chat with my friend over there, all right?
The
No, we just stand, I'll show you that in a minute. So it's appointed for men to die once and women too, but after this, the judgment. The judgment involves determining your innocence or your guilt. Now, the Bible says all have sinned, all have broken the law of God, and we've fallen short of the glory of God. We're all guilty. All of us are guilty. There is no hope of ourselves of innocence. But here's the other warning. The God of the Bible has appointed a day already on which he will judge the world in righteousness by the man whom he has ordained. Whoever you are, wherever you're from, whatever you're doing here today, your clock is ticking just like mine. The day of judgment has already been set. God is already working towards that day. How will you be found on that day? If you say, well, I'm a good religious person, you're guilty. If you say, well, I try my best, you're guilty. If you say, well, I'll turn and say I'm sorry, you're guilty. Saying you're sorry doesn't make you right before a judge. You stand before a judge and you say, yes, judge, I murdered that person, I did that. And the judge says, good, some honest repentance. And you say, can I go free? And the judge says, can you heck? You still got to be punished for it. People think that God is less just than an earthly judge. An earthly judge says, if you've murdered and say you're sorry, so you should. And people think that they'll stand before a just, holy God who has all the evidence, and they'll just say, well, I didn't know. The God of the Bible has set a day on which he will judge the world with righteousness. Your life, my life, is already counting down, minute by minute, hour by hour, day by day, week by week, month by month. So what's going to happen on that day? If you've not got right with God, you have a serious problem. And so there's a warning. Look at what the Bible says. Watch therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour in which the Son of Man is coming. So if you thought that someone was going to burgle your house, this is what Jesus says, if you thought someone was going to burgle your house, you'd be sat there with whatever, the shotgun, I don't know. You'd be waiting, you'd have the doors locked, you'd have it sorted. But the more precious thing that we have, our eternal soul, we've done nothing with it. We say, I'll deal with it. I'll get right with God on my deathbed. Well, here's the warning. Watch therefore, you know neither the day nor the hour on which the judge, the Son of Man, is coming. And also the warning is this. Behold, now is the accepted time. Behold, now is the day of salvation. Don't put off to tomorrow that which you can solve today. Once and for all, get right with God now. Don't wait until that day, which you may never get. Because if that day comes, if the day of judgment, the day of the Lord, the Bible refers to it, comes, he will say, depart from me, I never knew you. And you'll go to that place with weeping and gnashing of teeth, where your sin justly will be punished for all eternity. And you might say, wow, this is the best Christmas message I've ever heard. Well, you need to hear the problem and the warning so that the solution is actually of benefit to you. So when it says it's appointed for men and women to die once and after this judgment, so Christ was offered once to bear the sins of many. Your religion will not get you to heaven. You cannot, by good works, be right with a holy God. You've got to be perfect to enter heaven. Who is perfect but God? No one. So God, Christ Jesus, was offered once to bear the sins of many. Are you going to let that opportunity pass by? You say, oh, I'm okay, buddy. I'm all right, friend. I know where I'm going. Well, if you're not in Christ, you have no idea. Because if you did, you would flee for your life. Quite literally. Don't put off till tomorrow that which you can do today. Why don't you look at the Lord Jesus Christ for yourself today, so that you can have peace with God the Father, you can have your sins dealt with, you can have that day of judgment set in order, because God will give you a new heart and a new spirit to make you fit for heaven. So the question, obviously, we know the solution. Christ died for sinners like me and like you. If you've not put your trust in Christ, you will be guilty on the day of judgment. He will say, depart from me, I never knew you. And your eternal destination will be hell. Why would you want that this Christmas? I don't want that for you, and I'm a stranger. I want you to trust in the Lord Jesus Christ today, that you know on that day of judgment, you will be right with God. You will have forgiveness of sins, peace with God, and a place in heaven. So where will you go as you stand? Heaven or hell? If you are not trusting in the Lord Jesus Christ, to be very clear, hell is your current destination. But heaven is available for anyone who will believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and be saved. As you walk by today, the Lord Jesus Christ is God the Son, the second member of the Trinity. He says, those who believe in me, I will give a new heart and a new spirit. He will place God the Spirit in the hearts of anyone who will put their trust in him, and he will do the work necessary to make you fit for heaven. As you pass by, we're 15 minutes on from when I started. If you had 24 hours to live, you'd be thinking about this question. But you don't know how long you've got to live. The day of the Lord and the hour is already approaching. If you don't have that right today, who's to say you'll get the time to sort it tomorrow or the day after or the day after that? Why don't you seek the Lord today while he may be found? Call on him while he's near and have peace with God the Father through the Son, be given a new heart and a new spirit, and have a place in heaven rather than hell, which is what by nature we are destined for. You can take that from my hand. You can come and have a chat. You can challenge and question if you like. I love that. It's better that we find out while there is time, because the clock is ticking. You have 15 minutes less than when I began, and the clock will continue ticking until you stand before God as judge. Will you be innocent or guilty? Heaven or hell? Will you believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and be saved? Have a lovely Christmas, friends. Consider the greatest gift this Christmas is forgiveness of sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you. Have a lovely time. God bless you. Thank you.